Hi, good morning one and all. Last class we can discuss about how impulse is conducted. They have again three steps. One is polarized, second one is the depolarized, third one is the repolarized. See, polarized state is indicates resting potential. In this, in ICF intracellular fluid, they having more negative charge. In depolarized, what will happen? When you apply the external stimuli, the sodium is enter into the inside, gradually negative charges is decreasing, that is called as a depolarized. There the action potential is started. And repolarized, what will happen? When this membrane is saturated, due to the sodium is enter into the inside, after membrane is saturated, this sodium gates are closed. At that time, the potassium gates are opened. The potassium is moved from the ICF to the ECF. Okay. Now here, why the potassium gates are opened and it will be go outside? Because the negative charges is increasing. Here, inside the negative charges and outside is more positive charges. We have to maintain that a concentration gradient only impulse formation is takes place. Now, the time period between polarized state to the repolarized state, that period is called as a refractory period. Per second, how many impulses takes place means 1000 impulses takes place. See how much of fast this process it is. Here, refractory period is two types. One is absolute refractory period, second one is the relative refractory period. Absolute refractory period means, suppose when I apply a external stimuli, action potential is started. And then you have to apply secondary external stimuli, but the stimuli is not able to take place or there is no second action potential. That's why polarized to repolarized one period. It means totally this is one refractory period or it is one stimuli. The time period between the polarized to the repolarized one stimuli and not able to respond to the second stimuli, this total period is called as a absolute refractory period. That's why cannot initiate the second stimuli. Ante first two stimuli varaku agipoyi second stimuli ki inka respond kaakunda unte aa time period ni manam em antam ante absolute refractory period antam. సరే ఇప్పుడు నేను ఒక అన్నం ముద్ద తీసుకుని ఒక పిల్లవాడికి ఫాస్ట్గా పెట్టాను. వాడు తింటూ ఉంటూ ఇంకోటి పెడితే తినగలడా? ఇట్ ఇస్ సమ్ వాట్ వెరీ డిఫికల్ట్. ద సేమ్ థింగ్ ఇఫ్ యూ అప్లై ఏ స్టిములై, ద ప్రాసెస్ ఈజ్ కంప్లీటెడ్, ఆ టోటలీ దట్ ప్రాసెస్ ఈజ్ కాల్డ్ యాజ్ ఏ అబ్జల్యూట్ రిఫ్రాక్టరీ పీరియడ్. అండ్ దెన్ రిలేటివ్ రిఫ్రాక్టరీ పీరియడ్. రిలేటివ్ రిఫ్రాక్టరీ పీరియడ్ ఈస్ కోయిన్సైడ్ విత్ హైపర్ పోలరైజేషన్. వాట్ ఈస్ హైపర్ పోలరైజేషన్? సపోజ్ సి ఇన్ రీపోలరైజ్ స్టేట్ వాట్ విల్ హ్యాపెన్? ద పొటాషియం గేట్స్ ఆర్ ఓపెన్. సపోజ్ లాస్ట్ క్లాస్ ఐ సెడ్ నౌ టోటలీ 10 నెగిటివ్ ఛార్జెస్ ఈజ్ దే అండ్ పొటాషియం 5 potassium is present. When repolarized state, the potassium gates are open. I think a 3 potassium will be go out. Before that, here only negative charges is there, minus 10, here plus 5. Finally, you can get inside negative charges, minus 5. What I said, in resting state, compulsory inside more negative charges is present. Now, this 3 potassium will be go out. What will happen? Remaining how many is there? 2, minus 10, plus 2, you can get minus 8. Now what will happen inside? Negative charges is increasing. Outside, positive charges is increasing. You have to maintain that concentration gradient. Now, hyperpolarization means, suppose before that, when potassium gates are open, some amount of potassium will be go outside. At that time, you have to maintain average how many millivolts of energy? Minus 70 millivolts of energy. I already said that one. Now, if this potassium gates are lazy gates, it means after potassium will be go out, they want to close like this, but they not able to close slowly, step by step, lazily it will be closes. At that time, the potassium will be go out. That's why the remaining potassium also, some amount of potassium also will be go out. What will happen? The negative charges is more increasing. That's why, see, if potassium gates are lazy gates, more potassium will be go outside, then increasing of more negative charges inside. When it is reaches to the minus 90 millivolts, that state is called as what? Hyperpolarized state. That's why after repolarize, next one is what? Hyperpolarized state. That's why the time period between the polarized to the hyperpolarized, it is coincide. From there, it will be enter into the polarized. Now, total this period is called as a relative refracted period. Now say absolute refractive period can takes more time or relative refractive period it can be takes more time. Relative refractive period can takes more time. Why? Because from here to here it can takes more time. Now, the next, how the impulse formation is transferred. Suppose in this region, when I apply external stimuli like this, here concentration gradient is started. Now, electrical impulse or nerve impulse is started from axon, axon to axon terminals, axon terminals to synaptic nodes. Now, what are the impulse formation is takes place here? This impulse is a transfer from the one neuron to the another neuron to the another neurons continuously. This is the procedure. Now, the impulse is reaches to the synaptic node. Now, I can take one synaptic node. This is the synaptic node and this one is the axon terminals. In synaptic nodes, chemical storage vesicles is present, that is called as a synaptic vesicles, and this one is the synaptic membrane. This is presynaptical membrane, this is the postsynaptical membrane, and they having a receptor, that is the thing. Now, when this nerve impulse is reaches to synaptic nodes, at that time, see, this is one neuron, post neuron, this one is the pre-neuron. Here this junction is called as a synapse and they having a space that is called as a synaptic cleft and filled with a fluid, that fluid is called as a synaptical fluid. I already said, in synaptical fluid, the most abundant element is water, calcium. When this impulse is reaches to here, this calcium enter from the synaptic fluid to synaptic nodes. How? By the process of higher concentration to lower concentration, that calcium is enter and binds to synaptic vesicles. When this calcium is binds to synaptical vesicles, synaptical vesicles is activated and touches the synaptic membrane. When this vesicles can touches the synaptical membrane, the vesicle is ruptured. These synaptic vesicles, they having what? Chemical substances. That chemical substances is releases outside. that chemical substances is releases outside. That process is called as a exocytosis. Cyte indicates cell. Exo means come outside. That's why that chemical substances is come outside, enter into the synapse region. Now that chemical substances is called as a neurotransmitters. This neurotransmitters, either it is excitatory or inhibitory. Now suppose maybe either it is excitatory, this is binds to receptors. Now this message is enter into the next neuron. This is post neuron of the dendrites. I already said this dendrites having, they having channels, that is a ligand gated channels. These neurotransmitters is received by the ligand gated channels of dendrites. From the dendrites, this message is reaches to the cell body, towards to cell body. That's why it is a afferent process. From the cell body to axon, axon to axon terminals, axon terminals to synaptic nerves. Another calcium will be enter, and remaining process is same as that of continuous, like this. Like this, the transmission is takes place.